Babatunde Oshotimehin was born on the 6th of February 1949 in Ijebu Igbo, southwestern Nigeria, into a big family, a loving household of not just brothers and sisters, but cousins, nephews, and nieces. The son of a teacher, he was an avid learner whose hardworking parents instilled in him the value of education. He attended Igbobi College Lagos, one of the oldest and most prestigious colleges in Nigeria. After completing his secondary school education, the young Babatunde, raised to be humble and sensitive to the needs of others, set his sights towards becoming a medical doctor and contributing to society. Little did he know that he was already laying the foundation for a life lived in service to humanity. He trained at the foremost University College Hospital in Ibadan, Nigeria, where he qualified to be a medical doctor in 1972. He then proceeded to the University of Birmingham in the UK, where he received a doctorate in medicine in 1979. He was appointed professor of clinical pathology at the University of Ibadan. He was later elected as the provost of the College of Medicine, a position in which he served with merit between 1990 and 1994. Dr. Oshotimehin was an eminent scholar. He was a member of the Royal College of Physicians in the UK and a fellow of endocrinology at Cornell University between 1979 and 1980. He was a visiting fellow at the Harvard Center for Population and Development Studies between 1996 and 1997. Driven by his passion to improve the health and well-being of women and young people in Nigeria, he served as the chairman of the National Action Committee on AIDS and as the Director General of Nigeria's National Agency for the Control of AIDS between 2002 and 2008. In recognition for his contributions to the nation, especially his critical role in Nigeria's national response to HIV and AIDS, he was awarded the esteemed honor of Officer of the Order of the Niger in 2005. On the 17th of December 2008, Dr. Oshotimehin was appointed the Nigerian Minister of Health, overseeing a ministry serving 150 million Nigerians. He united all 36 states to build a national health plan focused on primary health care. Dr. Oshotimehin became the fourth executive director of UNFPA, the United Nations Population Fund, on the 1st of January 2011.
I, Babatunde Oshotimehin, solemnly declare and promise to exercise in all loyalty, discretion, and conscience the functions entrusted to me as an international civil servant of the United Nations.
During his tenure, he spearheaded efforts by the international community to advance the milestone consensus of the International Conference on Population and Development.
Every woman and man has a right to choice, and every family should be able to choose without coercion how many children they want to have and space them accordingly.
He was never afraid of a challenge. His strong leadership helped keep the health and rights of the world's women and girls high on the global agenda.
It is my conviction that every country has enough resources to look after its people. It is about making the difficult decisions to provide those resources and divert it from other things which, you know, they might have been doing before, and focus on the issues of women and young girls and ensure that they get education and health services.
In conflicts like this, women and children are the ones who suffer most, and we must continue to ensure that we can look after them and protect them from such calamities.
He understood that the world's 1.8 billion young people are truly its greatest hope for the future.
There are 1.8 billion young people in the world.
and most of them are in the developing parts of the world, where they constitute the majority of the population. We believe at UNFPA that our ability to tap into the energies they bring, their vitality, their ability to create and innovate, which can be captured in the demographic dividend, would make growth happen in those parts of the world.
Within the framework of the Sustainable Development Goals, he vigorously championed a new transformative agenda for the fund: zero preventable maternal deaths, zero unmet demand for family planning, and the elimination of harmful practices against women and girls.
We must develop zero tolerance to women dying, giving life. And I think that's what UNFPA is committed to accomplishing with our partners and our country partnerships.
His global advocacy and leadership on the demographic dividend, which calls for increased investments in young people's education and health, including their sexual and reproductive health, led the African Union to launch the first ever roadmap to achieving the demographic dividend.
We're happy as an organization to have worked with the African Union in putting together the roadmap for the implementation of the theme of 2017, which is about reaping the demographic dividend in Africa.
As a wise person once said, if you want to go fast, go alone. But if you want to go far, go together.
Till the very end, he was a tireless advocate for the human rights and dignity of all people, particularly the most vulnerable adolescent girls.
The 10-year-old girl is one we need to protect so that we stop people making choices for them and we allow them the free space to grow.
He will be fondly remembered by his colleagues, the women and young people to whom he dedicated his life to serving, and most of all, by his loving family. Dr. Oshotime is survived by his wife of 44 years, Mrs. Olufunke Oshotime, 5 children, and several grandchildren.